Yeah, now it is recorded. Okay. So now what I do is, I already have some questions. Okay. Oh, there are so many sessions. Okay. Now please listen. I'll first tell you how things can be done here. Add an activity. Please see that there are two activities, hot pot and quiz. Please see the screen. Later you can try. Okay. Hot pot and quiz. It's a very long quiz. Please remember, because the faculty members are in Chennai campus, I can help them. But you guys are in Bhopal campus, please listen to it. Only my video can help you. Okay. So there is a hot pot and there is quiz. So hot pot is external quizzing. You have seen something like, ma'am, have you sent it?
Yes, sir.
To me?
Yes,
sir. Which email, ma'am? You sent ma'am? P.S. Pradeep Kumara. Yeah. So Anita ma'am, quiz. So already she has developed a quiz. First.jqz. Okay. So the file name is jqz in Hotpot. She already developed some questions. I don't know what are the questions answers. She has already developed. Okay. So I go and say Moodle course. So one thing is Hotpot. Another is quiz. I will go with quiz. Quiz is Moodle native quiz. So Moodle have its own quiz platform. This is very powerful. So I am going with this quiz add. In this name of the quiz. So what I do is Anita Yadav. Quiz from Anita. So I use this name so that people can understand. And whenever there is a star here, it is mandatory. So you have to compulsorily give this. No star, you can limit it, simply optional. So usually in the optional, what you can do is no negative marking. 4 out of 10 is considered to be pass. Considered as pass, you can put. So something. You are providing some information to the students. Then timing, open the quiz at what time, close the quiz at what time, or time limit 10 minutes. So there are two options, opening and closing. So I open this quiz at this time, close at this time. So let's say 10 minutes, there is a quiz for 10 minutes. Suppose the student come at the 9th minute, he will be given only 1 minute of time. So if you want to give a penalty, it's okay, fine. Sometimes what you do is, you can enable this 10 minutes. I close the quiz, that means I close my eyes. That means the quiz will not be visible to the students. Once everyone is there in the classroom, open the eyes so that everyone can see the quiz. Both options are possible. As of now, I am not enabling the timing, but I enable the time limit. 10 minutes quiz time. Then, when the time expires, what happens? I will remove this. Okay. When the time expires, what happens? Open attempts are submitted automatically. There is a grace period when open attempts can be submitted. Attempts must be submitted before time expires or they are not counted. So that means what? 100 questions are there. I attempted 85 questions. Now time limit is over. Now the student forgot to submit. Because he don't have time to submit, the quiz is over. How, what decision I can take? Open attempts are submitted automatically means whatever he has inputted for 85 questions, will be submitted. He gets the scores for 85 questions. Remaining 15, anyway, he has not attempted, no issues. But suppose, if you select this option, he has to submit. If he doesn't submit, then he'll get 0. He'll get 0. Okay, so by default, I enable this as open attempts are submitted automatically. Submission grace period, by default, it is disabled. This link is disabled. That means it is not admissible. Okay, grade. So grade to pass. What is the grade to pass? Grade by pass, there is a highlighted green. Fails are in red color. So 4. So grades totally 4 to pass. Because I already mentioned it there, I want to use. But don't use this here. Because when the students see that, they see red or green. Red means, oh, he got failed. Green means he feels that he is passed. So it is only to show them indication that it is fail or pass, but don't do that. Just only to show you there is an option available. How many attempts you are allowing? How many attempts? So by default I gave it as one attempt. That means beyond one attempt, if you don't give, it's fine. But suppose for practice problems, he can practice so many times, then he can give 1 or 2 or 3, any number of attempts he can give. Layout. In one page, how many questions you want to have? So in one page, I want to have 5 questions or how many questions? So up to 50 questions you can have in one page. Optimal being 5 questions. Navigation method free. There is another navigation method sequential. That means I attempted question number 1, then I want to go to question number 30. Then again I want to come to question number 12, then 17. I can go with any way possible. Sequential means without answering question number 1, I cannot go to 2. Without answering 2, I cannot go to 3. Okay. So let me give free. Question behavior. Don't do anything here. I given as deferred feedback. Deferred feedback. There are so many things. Deferred feedback with CBM, adaptive mode, no modality, immediate feedback. Immediate feedback means the time by which he is writing an answer, he gets the answer. Oh, this is wrong. This is right. Like that, he gets an answer. Or his nearby student will see, oh, this is the wrong answer, I need to select something else. So, deferred feedback means after he input all these things, the score will be revealed or not according to our option. Okay. Review options. Review options, you can see, I hide everything. There is only one tick available. During the attempt, there is a tick available. Everything is unticked. That means, during the attempt, whether correct? No, I don't want to show. I want to show the marks? No. Specific feedback? No. General feedback? No. Right answer? No. Overall feedback? No. Immediately after the attempt, I don't want to show anything. Immediately, later when the quiz is still open, I don't want to show anything. After the quiz is closed, I don't want to show anything. So, one advantage what I do is I click the marks here. That means, immediately after the attempt, I will show him the marks. But last 3 years onwards, we are not showing this to the students. The reason I am telling you, you are conducting an English final examination for 50 marks. Assign the student got 10 marks out of 50, 10. And you want to make the student pass. He got 10 marks, you know he is a well deserved student. You want to give him 30 marks and make him pass. You are putting 30. The student, what he will say? Hey, I got only 10, but I get passed. Alright. So, this was the case. One time it happened, we show the marks to the students, but we cannot add marks to them because they already know the marks. So, we abruptly fail some students. After that, what we did is, from the next exam onwards, we hide this column. Going to show marks, I can add whatever I can in the back end. I mean, it's a courtesy rule. Sometimes the student will be sitting for placement. If you put 2 or 3 questions right, he will be attending the placement. Because of that, he may be failed and he will be waiting for another opportunity. So that's why we will be denying this option. But now, since you want to see, I just enable this. Appearance. Okay, no issues. Extra restriction on attempts. Suppose you want to enter password for this quiz. Require password to open this quiz. Suppose your student, what you do is, we are conducting the exam in the campus. All your students are here, except 2 students are in some other laboratory. By the same time, they are writing exam, they will also write exam there. But you will be seeing only these students. So what you can you set a password here. You display the password, say the password in the classroom. The other 2 will be waiting for the password. Hey, we don't know what is the password. Okay, that is why this password is here. So let me use a password Pradeep here. In small letters. You can see that what password you are inputting, I am inputting Pradeep here. And save and return to course. Other things are optional. So my quiz is ready. Quiz from Adita Yadav. When I click this, attempts allowed 1. To attempt this quiz, you need to know the quiz password. Time limit 10 minutes. No questions have been added yet. Because I have created a quiz, but questions are not added. And I need to add the question. So, edit quiz. So, the edit quiz button, the questions will be added. Okay. So now when I go and check any question, so there are three things. Add a new question, add from question bank, add a random question. So let's say, let me go with question bank. No questions are there. No questions are there. Now I need to add my questions. So what do I do is, I come to the course again. I come to the course, click this, click more here. You can see question bank. You can see question bank. Questions categories import. Now we are going to import this question. Import means what? Which file we are using this among this? Can you tell me? Hot potatoes. We use a software called as hot potatoes. So we are going to import question from hot potatoes. So click hot potatoes. General category you can import. Default for MOOC. So I'll tell you why I need category. For example, English, I take English as an example. They want to conduct examination on prepositions, articles, what's the good word, superstitions. Like there are four topics. So I can have prepositions 100 questions, articles 100 questions, what's the good word 100 questions. Among the 100, I want to shuffle 10 questions to each student. So in that case, I can use category here, category 1. Articles, category 2, prepositions, category 3, what's the good word, something like that. Here I don't want to use any category because ma'am has prepared 10 questions, I want to use that. Choose the file. So I'll choose the file, anyway the file is already there. So what I do is, the file I already downloaded, drag and drop. Just click it here and the drop files here. So first.jkuz, import, click import. Once it is imported, there are totally 10 questions. Is it right, ma'am?
Yes.
10 questions. So the questions are, the manager of the group was a brilliant man. Dad's only weakness was that he hated to accept defeat. So she has prepared 10 questions like this. Continue. Now you can see default for MOOC. You can see there are in bracket 10 questions. So 10 questions are added in the MOOC. Okay. So 10 questions are added. Now I go back to my MOOC, this course, then go to the quiz. Where is the quiz? Quiz from Anita Yadav. So I click this quiz, then I can see edit quiz, edit option. What I do is add a random question. How many questions I can give? I have out of 10, how much I can give? You just give me a number. Out of 10 questions, let's say I will not give all the 10 to everyone. That's also fine. But I want to give out of 10, I want to give 5 questions at random. Out of 10, I want to give 5 at random. So add a random question. So select the category. So my category is bracket 10. Select the number of questions. How many? I'll give 5. Add random questions. So my 5 random questions are ready. Okay. And how much marks? Maximum grade 10. And total marks is 5. So out of total marks 5, my maximum grade is 10. Okay, so 10 marks. Okay, so I have done it. Now what I can do is, again I can go to MOOC in my course page. Go to the quiz here. Quiz from Anita Yadav. Click it. And attempt quiz now. When you attempt, it asks for a password. So I can input my password and start attempt. Now you can see there are 5 questions. You can see quiz navigation also available here. So see the timer is running. 9.49. We got 10 minutes I have given. The timer is running. So now my neighbors are so noisy. They dash always move furniture around first thing in the morning. They might not. What is the answer? They do. Okay. Anyway, we'll right or wrong, we'll see. The managers of the group was a brilliant man. Dash only. Weakness was that he had to accept defeat. Whom? Fine.
Who's
only? Oh, sir. Okay. There are more unemployed or unemployments?
Unemployed.
This thing. B, okay. Cache is primary memory, true or false? False. Dash apologized, I won't have been so upset at the time. Had he apologized? Huh? Fine, finish attempt. Let's see how much. So it will give you all the answers saved. If not, you go back. Now else you submit all and finish. There is one thing wrong. But as a student, I cannot see the answer. Ma'am, what is wrong? Oh, they will always move furniture. Okay, so 8 marks now. Because I am previewing now. As an administrator or faculty, I am previewing this question now. If a student writes an examination, so let me do the same thing here. Log out. The name of the student is VIT Bhopal 8. So, VIT Bhopal 8. VIT Bhopal 8. Okay, so in the VIT Bhopal 8, I come to this Moodle course and attending the quiz now. Quiz from Anita. So, no negative marking. So, attempt quiz now. It asks for a password. So, I click this. Cache is primary memory. Let me say true. A singular matrix is, because now see the options are changed. Because at random it fetches me 5 questions. Now the different set of 5 is coming. A singular matrix is mathematics faculty. Has the determinant value 0, sir? Okay. The success of Regent High Hotel dashed by its low vacancy rate of only about 2% almost whole year can be determined by its. Mrs. Greeny is our global sales manager with special control for the Asian region. Okay. Responsibility also can be, anyway, responsibility will say. Laplace transform converts differential equation into? Fine, finish attempt. Submit all and finish. See that 4 out of 5, 4, your final grade for this quiz is 8 out of 10. Okay, so now it is done. So log out, I log into my login again. So student have attempted. Okay, so the course name is Moodle course. You can go to the quiz again and see that attempts, one attempt. Click this attempt and you can see which question is wrong. So question number 1 is wrong. What is wrong? The answer is cache memory is false, primary memory. So you can see, if you want to see which is the correct answer, this is the wrong answer. The correct answer is false. Okay. It shows the correct answer and others he has written it well. And you can see it will show you the graph also. And you can download the mark, Excel sheet, Microsoft Excel. Download the table as Microsoft Excel. Download. Very easy option. So this way I can able to create a quiz. Pardon? Oh, you want to see that? Fine, I'll show you that. Attempts 1. Download. I'll open this. Surname VAT Bhopal, first name VAT Bhopal, email address state finished, started on, completed, 1 minute, 1 second taken, grade 8 out of 10. So these things will be there in the Excel sheet. Only one student, so it will give overall average also. How much, what is average for this class? Okay. So, this is a perfect tool for quiz. Can you do it? I'll stop the recording.